Up to this point in the tutorial, we have been using relative cell references. Excel also makes use of absolute references. The difference between the two types of absolute or relative has to do with the positioning of the cell that the formula is referencing within the worksheet. When you use a relative reference to a cell in your worksheet, if you change the structure of your data, Excel will automatically adjust the cell reference based on the new location of the cell in your worksheet. Notice that right here I have a relative reference to A1, so that's column A, row 1. There's no dollar signs, it's just listed as A1. That is a relative reference. Now below this, I have an absolute reference. Now, if you use an absolute reference in a formula, you are directing Excel to always go to that cell in your worksheet, that row and that column that comprise that cell. If you change your data structure, Excel will not adjust the cell reference to reflect the data structure change. It will go to that location, that row and that column on your worksheet, no matter what you've done to the data. Notice that in this absolute reference, you have dollar signs in front of the column and the row reference. This is an absolute reference. You can also have mixed references. And by a mixed reference, you are making either the row or the column absolute, and then the other row or column reference would be relative. So here, in this reference, I have my column of A as relative, but my row has a dollar sign in front of it, so it is absolute. Excel will always go to row 1, but the column can change from A to B to C because this is a mixed reference. Also note that here I have another mixed reference where the column is absolute, but the row is relative. And again, by making the column absolute, Excel will always look at column A, but the row can change from row 1 to row 2 to 3 or wherever your data changes within the data structure. Now you can toggle between these four types of references within your formula when you reference a cell. So notice if I choose this absolute reference here in A7, up here in my formula, if I highlight that cell reference and then press the F4 function key on my keyboard, I will toggle between a mixed reference, another mixed reference, a relative reference, and back to an absolute reference. And it's as easy as that to adjust your reference. You can either toggle between it by highlighting the reference in the formula bar, or if you want to just simply type it with the appropriate use of the dollar sign to make either the row or the column or both row and column absolute. Now you will be using references, absolute, relative, and mixed references throughout your formula development. This movie is just to show how to change your referencing and to give you a brief introduction or instruction on how to use those references. Let's go ahead and move on to the next movie.